وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين أما بعد سلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته One of the most important pillars of Islam, Rukn al-Islam, is Hajj. And it is wajib upon everyone who can afford to go. Now, as far as affording to go is concerned, it has been explained in Sharia that it means that the person who wishes to go must have enough money at his disposal to spend for the passage, one. Second, to be able to maintain himself while he is in Hajj for as many days as he is there. And third, to leave behind enough so that when he comes back, he is potentially or actually able to maintain himself then. And if he has left behind the family, then the family ought to be able to maintain itself while he is away on Hajj. When these three things are completed, then it is called istita'at or mustati', and therefore it is wajib to go. Now, for those people upon whom it is not wajib, because they don't have that much money, they will not go. And those people who are in debts, that means they are indebted to people, they have not paid back the money yet, and if they have enough money, but that money is just to be paid out to those to whom he owes, then he will first pay his qard, that means whatever he owes, and if nothing is left, or whatever is left is so little that he cannot go for Hajj, he will not go for Hajj. Because it is wajib that one goes to Hajj with no debts on him. Now, when we talk of debts, it must be clarified that debts are of two types. There are debts which every millionaire has. If you ask him, the more richer you are, the more indebted you are. That is the sign of being a millionaire these days. Now, if people come and say that I owe the bank, you see, there is an overdraft. Well, that is not considered as debt, because that is a system of economics that has been prevailing. Actually, the man is worth millions, but he is trading with bank's money. And therefore, that is not a debt, and simply because it is an arranged loan. That means it has got to be paid over a particular period, and it is not immediately to be paid. But now, for example, we had in East Africa, for example, Russian merchants who used to give us ration on invoice. Now, if I'm going to Hajj and the Russian merchant has got a bill against me and I owe him some money and I'm paying him every month, this time Hajj has come between, in the middle of the month, and when I come back, inshallah, I'll pay him. It is a known arrangement, then that is not a debt. Or a telephone bill or gas bill or electricity bill and things like this which are being paid, these things are not considered as debts. Otherwise, no one will ever go for Hajj. But personal loans or loans which have been paid and are immediately payable on demand, or the demand is already on. That means the person whom I owe has already been to me twice, three times, 100 times to say, please pay me now, and I'm not paying him, and I go to Hajj, that Hajj is not sahih in a sense that the ihram that I will wear will be ghasb, unless the fellow I owe himself out of his own pleasure and on his own accord comes and tells me, I don't mind, you can go. Similarly, on those ladies who are not working, the wives who are not working, Hajj will not be wajib upon them unless the husband settles gift upon them and say that I make Hajj wajib upon you by way of this gift, that means we will go together. Then, or mother or sister. But if they are earning and they have enough money, then it will become wajib upon them to go for Hajj, provided that their security and their honor is not at risk. Because a married woman going alone, or a spinster going alone, it might not sometimes be safe. So she has got to consider two factors, her honor and respect, and her security. If these things are coupled with money, then she will go for Hajj, and it will be wajib upon her to go. Hajj is wajib once in lifetime. And inshallah ta'ala, as days go by, we will be considering Hajj. First, as to what it all means. Because it pains, sometimes it pains me and all of you, it will pain you to hear that many people, when they go to Hajj, instead of coming back appreciating what they have done and seen, they come back with such views which sometimes are terrifying. They come and tell their Hindu friends that there is no difference between you and us. You go around your murti and we go around Kaaba. You see? And some of them come and say, had I known that Hajj is so difficult, I would not have gone. And things like that. So it is because of this that I feel that Hajj must be understood first as to what is the philosophy of Hajj.